this is going to be on the parabola, standard form parabola equation right here, and I'm going to speak about the distances between any point on the parabola and the focus, and that how that distance to the directrix is the same, and where in the world this 4 comes from, this 4P, I'm going to put a little circle over it, that 4 right there, and it comes from using this distance factor, or not factor, I don't know why I said that, this distance thing stuff. And so if you always do x1 minus x2 squared plus y1 minus y2 squared and square root it, and that is the, you know, if you put a point here and here, it would be this distance squared, whoops, that was great, this distance squared plus this distance squared, and then you take the square root of it and it'll be that distance. And that's what we're going to be doing here. So let me get rid of this and fill that in. I should have had the colors already set. Oops. And then, alright, I set these up. This is the point to the focus right here. Let me draw a little line down to this. And this is the point to the directrix over here. We're going to show that they're equal. All right, this is the x of the point, which is this x, value, minus the x of the focus. Well, the x of the focus, I mean, I'm sorry. Wait a minute, did I mess up there? Yeah, okay. Because the focus has the same value as the vertex, because this parabola is opening up and down, so the x values, they share the same x. So the focus is the same x as, so you just use this h. And then we're adding to that, where are we? We're here, the y value. The y value of the point is the y value of the point. And we're subtracting the y value of the focus, which that is the k plus this p right here. And remember, I'm going to tell you why this is really about that 4, why that 4 is there, why this works. And so, and when we're going to set this, we're setting this equal to the point to the directrix, is this right here, straight down. Well, the x of this point and the x of the directrix, or the directrix is a line, but you're going straight down because it's the shortest distance. And that's why I put a little dx here. That's that x. So that's just going to zero out, because that's whatever this is minus whatever that is. Well, so that's going to zero. I'm going to put a little zero there. And then this over here is the point's y value, which is this value here, and then the y value of this. Well, that's just going to be the vertex minus the p. See, this one's plus the p because it goes up, and this one's down because it goes down. And this only because the parabola is going up. And so I know there's a lot of wording in this. After a couple of practices, it'll be straight. Now, I ought to relate this to this example. Let me pause it and think about that. Well, I'm just going to go ahead and finish it standalone, this example, to show why this is, and I might do another video on putting that one. Well, I've already done that. I guess I won't need to do it again. Okay, so right, this right here, we're just going to take this and leave it alone. You notice there, that's it right there, x minus h squared. And this right here, we can distribute this negative here, and it becomes a trinomial. It's going to become y minus k minus p. And let me pause it and just duplicate that. All right, There's that. We'll distribute that in a, or we'll foil that in a second. Let me put a little equal sign right here. And then this zero is out, so we can ignore that. And that's because the x value of the point and the directrix, wherever the point is, it's the same, so that's a zero. And so then we've got y minus a minus. So let's distribute this negative, and that's just going to come y minus k plus p. Let me pause it and duplicate. All right, so now we're about to distribute this over this and that over that. So say real quick, and then I'll just type it out neat. My fantastic hand writing skills are. All right, so y times y is y squared. Y times minus k is a minus yk. Y times minus p is a minus yp. Minus k times y is a minus yk. Minus k times minus k is a k, positive k squared. And minus k times minus p is a positive k. Minus p times y is yp. Minus p times minus k is a plus pk. And minus p times minus p is a plus p squared. And then you do the same thing I just said there for this. I'm going to pause it and just write it out for both. They're not the same, but they're close. Alright, now, and some of these are going to cancel, because if they're the same sign, they're going to cancel. So, like for instance, you have a y squared here and a y squared there. Well, if I subtracted y squared on this side and I subtracted there, they cancel. So if they're even signs, I'm going to put a line through it like this. Let's see, I'm going to go, that cancels with this. The p squareds will cancel because they're the same sign. And the k squareds will cancel. And then we've got some like terms here that we can group. Let me pause it and organize that. Well, let me finish canceling out these even same signs here. All right, there's a minus yk right here. And here's a minus yk. The minus yp, the yps are not going to cancel because there's a minus yk. Is there another minus? There's, all right, there's another one for here. For here. And then a kp. See that kp, that's positive. This one's negative. So I'm gonna, if I add kp, it'd come over here positive. Pk, that's, I think that's it. Let me pause it and make sure. Okay. That's all that. I mean, I just combined like terms and got this right here. And then I sent this over. And that became 4yp minus 4k. And for this, these have a common factor of 4p exist in both of those, so you can pull out a 4p. You know, you vacuum out that multiplication by 4p, and it just leaves the y minus k. And then on this side, we still had the binomial squared. It was x minus h. And then let me see if we want to review or anything. I mean, it's just, well, not it's just, but you want to build this back so that it, you can put a 4 there. And that's why that 4 is there, is because the sum of all these guys, there's 4 of them. And that's that. I'll review this and probably end up wanting to redo it because I messed up something.